Hi! Last year, around Halloween, we brought you our capacitive touch sensor video, which you could use to spook victims reaching into your candy bowl. Like I mentioned in that video, my favorite thing about this holiday is that I get to wear a cape outdoors. But a close second is the fact that I get to strap electronics to my clothing and call it a creative costume.
A marathon brainstorming session of our R&D team over lunch last Tuesday yielded our official NerdKits Halloween costume for the year, the Human Theremin.
Here's a clip of it in action.
A theremin is a musical instrument that is played without any physical contact with the instrument. It has two antennas that sense the position of the performer's hands. One hand controls the pitch of the note, and the other controls the volume or amplitude of the note.
For our project, we simplified the concept a little and are using two infrared LED and phototransistor pairs, one pair mounted on each wrist. The infrared LED is emitting infrared light, which bounces off the musician's hands and back into the phototransistor. When the player moves his or her hand closer, more light bounces back and is detected by the phototransistor.
Here is a look at the simple circuit that runs a hand position detector. On the LED side, we use a current limiting resistor so we can dictate the amount of current going through the LED. On the other side, we use the fact that the phototransistor will pass a small current based on how much infrared light it is receiving. This current will flow through the resistor and create a voltage across it. Remember, V equals IR. We take that voltage and run it over to the analog to digital converter on our microcontroller.
On the microcontroller, we use PWM to create a triangle wave. In our Making Music with a Microcontroller video, we show you how you can use PWM to create a square wave to make musical notes. In this project, we went with a triangle wave because it sounded smoother and less scratchy, and ultimately just spookier. Let's take a second to talk about how we can create a triangle wave using PWM. With PWM, you're stuck outputting square waves of a certain duty cycle. We can vary that duty cycle to create the output value we want. So to create a triangle wave, we first output a value of 1, then 2, and so far up the line up to 255, then back down again. If you smooth out these pulses over time, you get a triangle wave. Here on the yellow trace, you are seeing the PWM signal on an oscilloscope. If I scroll across, you can see the duty cycle increasing and then decreasing. On the green trace, we are seeing a smoothed out version of the signal, and if I zoom out, you can see the triangle wave. To make a higher pitch triangle wave, we just increase the duty cycle by 2 at every go-around, which means we reach 255 faster, making the frequency twice as high.
In order to give us more resolution in the variability of the frequency, and not have to resort to using floating point numbers, we used a fixed point decimal representation. This is actually nothing too complex, but it can take a bit to wrap your head around it if you're not used to it. The basic idea is this. Instead of representing our step size using an 8-bit integer, we represent it using a 16-bit integer, and just pretend amongst ourselves that there is a decimal point separating the bottom 8 bits from the top 8 bits. When it comes time to actually increase the PWM value, we chop off the top 8 bits and use that. This means that in order to increase the number by 1, we have to add 256 to it. Anything less we add would increase it by a fractional amount. So adding 128 to the number actually increases the step size by half. This might sound like a really strange thing to do, but having the ability to increase the step size by a fractional amount lets us create that really smooth pitch change as your hand moves up and down. If you are curious about this, take a look through the source code for this project, and can be a very useful trick to know when speed prevents you from using floating point math. To actually output the sound, we just use our piezoelectric buzzer at the output of the PWM. Take a look at our Making Music with a Microcontroller video for more on how the buzzer turns a voltage into a sound. The direct output of the PWM was sufficiently spooky enough for us. You might try adding a low-pass filter to yours if you want a smoother sound, or you could hook up a real speaker if you want to be louder and draw even more attention to yourself.
What makes this costume great is that it has an interactive component to it. Now, when you're at a Halloween party and someone asks you what you're dressed as, you have more than a one-word answer followed by an awkward silence. Instead, you can show them how to use your costume and proceed to have a roaring good time as your project becomes the life of the party. We hope you have learned a little bit about PWM and using IR as a close-range distance sensor, or at worst, got a neat idea for a Halloween costume. For more information about our kits, or more videos like this one, visit us at www.nerdkits.com.